to achieve it by qualifying right now.
What's wrong with you? I'm sitting here in a wheelchair. I'm hurt.
I know you're hurt. And so is your opponent, Randy Orton.
What is your malfunction? I am hurt. I cannot compete. And you can't make me.
You said you wanted a match with John Cena. Here's your chance. Take it or forfeit.
You do that and I'll quit.
Well then, ladies and gentlemen, on account of a forfeit, the winner and qualifying for the Fatal 4-Way, Randy Orton.
Batista quitting, Randy Orton, John Cena, Sheamus, and Edge will go on to finish the field for what will be a huge Fatal 4-Way WWE Championship match at the first ever Fatal 4-Way event. The odds are stacked against the champ. Can John Cena leave with his title?
Ladies and gentlemen, it is time for our pros to huddle up. We're going to tally up the pros poll, and when we come back, someone's going home! Gentlemen, you guys know the deal. Your hearts are racing, your stomach is churning. You're hoping that you're not last in the pros poll. With that said, let's see the pros poll and find out who will be eliminated.
Wade Barrett remains number one. Evan Otunga remains number two.
Okay, Justin Gabriel, please step forward. Heath Slater, please step forward. You guys have come so close. One of you will be going home. The other one will make it to our season finale. Are you ready to find out who's gonna be eliminated? Let's see the pros poll.
Now the moment.
Heath Slater, remind the WWE Universe who your pro is.
Christian.
Christian, I'd like to ask some insight. Why exactly was Heath Slater eliminated? What were your pros saying during the tally?
Well, to be honest with you, you know, I thought the cards were kind of stacked against Heath from the very start. I told him it was going to be a dogfight, and he was going to scratch and claw for everything that he was going to get, even if he was going to get close to winning this thing. I think my peeps felt, Heath, I really think you could have done it. But, you know, you have guys over here like Chris Jericho, who's obviously biased towards his guy. And, you know, anybody other than Wade Barrett, he's not really going to have a good thing to say. You know, I can't really put a finger on exactly what it was, Heath, but I still think you have a big future. You got a lot of work to do, but I still see big things for you, and I'm proud of you.
Okay, Christian, thank you. Miz, if your jaw is okay, can you tell us why you voted Heath Slater off of NXT?
I can. The reason I feel that Heath Slater was voted off of NXT is because you never showed us the wow. You never let loose. You never gave us your all. I mean, I couldn't feel the passion from you. I couldn't feel it in your heart. When you come to WWE, you come and you bring it full throttle every day, every single time you have. If you have 1 minute, you bring it out here no matter what. And I felt that sometimes you were good, sometimes you were off. You can never be off in the WWE.
United States Champion R-Truth, your thoughts on Heath Slater's elimination?
Truth is, Slater, you bust your butt out here, you did everything that was asked of you, but now you're finding out, and the WWE Universe knows, here is the survival of the fittest. Best luck next time.
And Chris Jericho, please give us your thoughts.
To be quite frank with you, Matt, it's axiomatic that Heath Slater would be eliminated. It just didn't matter what order, because Otunga will be eliminated, Gabriel will be eliminated, and Wade Barrett will win NXT and become the next WWE superstar. But Barrett, you can't be losing to a clown like Justin Gabriel again, or to Otunga. You're too good for that. So take your head out of your rear end. The fact that you're number one, four, five, 6 weeks in a row, it puts you in a different plane. It's hard being the best, but on NXT, you are the best. So start acting like it. Do you understand what I'm saying to you right now?
Thank you, Chris Jericho. Heath, buddy, what do you got to say? You're going home.
Well, I guess all good things must come to an end. But I've done far too much in such little time to be going anywhere. I was the first rookie to beat a pro. I was the first rookie to win a challenge. In WWE Magazine, they rated me best new nickname and the most impressive debut, Miz. I had to go against the big red machine Kane, and he was the only one that ended my undefeated streak. And that leads me to you, Chris. Six-time world champion. The man that says he is the best at what he does. That man right there beat Stone Cold Steve Austin and The Rock in one night. And I beat you. Pros, you might have pulled the plug on the one-man rock band. But ladies and gentlemen, get ready for the encore, because I'm about to blow your mind.
How about a nice hand for Heath Slater, who has been eliminated? Next week is the season finale of NXT, and one of these rookies will be the WWE's next breakout star. Find out who it's going to be next week on NXT.
The season finale of NXT next week. Who will become the WWE's next breakout star?